Welcome to
Grace
Brethren
Junior
Senior
High
School.
Believing in one.
Hello, my name is Jane Fernandez. I am a junior and I play the trumpet, drums, and guitar.
Hello, my name is Daniel Yoon. I'm a sophomore and I play bass guitar in
Hello, Grace. My name is Ian Graham. I'm a sophomore and I play the electric bass in Grace Brethren.
Hello, my name is Jake Arnold. I'm a sophomore and I play trumpet for the Grace Brethren High School.
My name is Michael Garvin. I'm a freshman and I play the alto saxophone in Grace.
Hello, my name is Nicholas Avery. I'm a sophomore and I play the alto saxophone in Grace Brethren High School.
My name is Jake Fries. I'm a freshman. I play the alto saxophone in Grace Brethren High School Jazz Band.
Hi, my name is Zach Moore. I'm a sophomore and I play trombone in Grace Brethren's High School Jazz Band. Today we are honored to perform a song first made famous by the iconic Louis Armstrong and recently arranged for our ensemble by Danny Rossetti. It's about hope and love and appreciating the beauty of the world around us and God's goodness in relationships. We pray that you find joy and hope in our performance of What a Wonderful World.
Thank you. So Lord, I run to you. No one else will do. Lord, you said we'd face trouble, pain, and fear, but to be of good cheer, be of good cheer, for you have overcome the world.
So Lord, I run to you. No one else will do. Lord, you said we face trouble, pain, and fear, but to be of good cheer, be of good cheer, for you have overcome the world.
Hello everyone, my name is Jane Fernandez. We are the Grace Brethren Combined Bands and we'll be performing the song Birdland by Weather Report. Thank you for listening. One, two, one, two, three, four.
Thank you. being able to be with the rest of my classmates.
He took my answer.
My friends.
Being able to hang out with people I normally don't hang out with.
Everything was, even though we lost a lot of stuff, was being able to get to see some people.
It's fun having going to school, but also staying home because you can do things with your friends and sleepovers and stuff like that. But also you still get the school experience, so that's cool.
I'm put on the spot. I don't really know, friends, I guess, but they're not here. Kate's not here.
Part of my senior year was getting to actually come back to school and see all my friends and be able to be participating in choir and ceramics class. So that was really nice because I know other people from other schools didn't get to do that.
That'll be over in 3 months.
This year, I just feel like it's been fun coming back here and getting a little sense of normalcy because of COVID. So I get to see my friends again that I haven't seen in a long time. And also just like the face-to-face relationships with our teachers, you don't get that on Zoom. So now we actually can have good conversations with them. So yeah, that's probably my favorite part.
Not having school every day.
My favorite part is to be able to be back on campus after such a long time being in COVID and having to be on distance learning. It's great to be able to be back with friends, be able to see them, and start to rebuild that community we had on campus.
Yes, New York, it's really us, Barnaby and Cornelius.
All the guests of Mr. Heckle are feeling great and look spectacular.
What a knack there is to that, acting like a born aristocrat.
We got elegance if you wait. Got elegance you can never ever carry.
It's all.
Well-bred agree, Minnie Fay has pedigree.
Exercise your wireless wings tonight. We are out with diamond gems tonight.
Could they be misleading us?
Silver spoons were used for feeding us.
We got elegance if you might. Got elegance you can never ever carry.
And bows to us.
We got elegance. We were born with elegance.
Have you noticed when I hold my cup, the saucer never moves?
And the way I keep my pinky up into a totally proves that
we got elegance. We got and with elegance, we'll carry it all.
Hi, my name is Kevin Hall, and I teach Bible here at Grace Berlin High School, and it's my privilege to talk to you today about the power of one. Romans 15, 5, and 6 really frame everything that we're doing here today. It's a verse that talks about the God of all encouragement who gives us unity, who pulls us together in order that we may glorify God with one voice. The message is a message of hope. As I looked up the definition of hope in the dictionary, it's interesting. It's something that's wishful, that's hopeful, but yet we know from the Bible that hope is so much more. Something solid, something you can stand on. It actually has to do with trust. One thing that I've told the students, and actually I have to tell myself often, is you trust somebody that you know. And this is the message of the God that we want to bring to you today. It's a message of hope. It is a message that really revolves around the gospel. And it's a message of beauty. Beauty is something that has captured my heart, not only in my life, but also as it comes to the God of all beauty, the God of all goodness. This is the God that we are talking about today. And the one who brings unity, I think the only lasting unity from what we see around in this world as we struggle, and it has been a hard year, as we look at any kind of hope that we can get, the hope that we have that is solid comes from Jesus Christ. That is the message of the gospel. And what I'm amazed at when it comes to the gospel is this, is the God who is most beautiful sent his son. And actually in that action, we see beauty beyond comprehension. That God would actually step into time and live the life that we couldn't live and take our place on the cross and then rise again. That is the gospel message. And that is the message that unites us all. That's the message that gives us encouragement, that gives us endurance. Why? Because the God who came takes away any kind of dividing wall between us, between himself first and foremost, but then between every one of us. And we live in a divisive context. We live in a divisive age, and yet at the same time, when we understand the gospel, it is the gospel of unity, and it is that which is most beautiful. And I tell the students this often, that we trust somebody that we know. And as we get to know God, we get to know that He is the God who is infinite. He's the God of all grace. He's the God of all love. He is the God of all beauty. And if that's the case and we know Him, then we begin to see that beauty, that goodness, that grace work itself out in our lives. That is the message of the gospel, that Christ came, that Christ gave. And that is huge. That is beautiful. That is the power of one. And that is what we're here to proclaim to you today.
My eyes to the hills. This year was not the year we planned. It seemed like it was shifting sand.
We made a choice to keep standing tall, even though some of us began to fall.
We tried to live life, give life, make the most of our life.
Learn to lose the things we loved, learn to rise above.
The non-normal, there was no formal.
A to L and M to Z were all that we could be.
Every day from the start, stand 6 feet apart.
So we learned to find a new way, working remotely from March through May.
We learned to work together, make things better.
We leaned on Jesus every day, He made the way.
We know our future will be brighter, because we've become fighters.
We won't stand divided, because now we're united.
And when this year is said and done, we will be the strongest seniors. Sincerely, Class of 2021.
Hello, my name is Matthew Blank, and I play the tenor and soprano saxophones in the Grace Brethren Junior High Advance Band. We really enjoyed the process of learning and recording this song. It was written by Paul McCartney and arranged specifically for our ensemble by Danny Orsetti. Thank you for watching, and we hope you enjoy our performance of Hey Jude.
Thank you.
welcome to Grace Brethren Junior Senior High School's first ever virtual art show. We want to recognize our students and their hard work under the direction of our art teacher, Carrie Rushing. Please enjoy our visual arts display from our school to your home.
Well, what a great show that we were able to watch. And I'm always amazed at the talent that God has bestowed upon all our students. And it's so fun to see that come into fruition, even in a tough year where we had to do things a little differently. On behalf of the administration here at Grace, our church, and myself personally, I just want to say thank you. Thank you to all our families. What a weird, strange, hard, glorious year where we are again reminded that God has been faithful to us, that he is our hope in Jesus Christ. And I just want to say thank you to you for your faithfulness to not only our school and its community, but to your students. We are committed to them, to see them being trained in a biblical worldview to become more like Jesus Christ. And we saw God's hand work that way this year. So once again, we just want to say thank you to you, our families, our friends, and our students. And we hope that God has much in store for 2021 and 2022.